up top, one after sign. Standard Treecko. I cannot believe it. That was zero encounters. Sub 8 talking to Norman. It's insane. Tackle miss. The bot's dead right now for some reason. I don't know why. .948 gym exit, by the way. Who's ready for turn one sand attack into a dead run? Cause I sure am. That's the third time I've missed on this fight today with no sands. Okay, that crit is insanely good. This is the pie attempt. Truly. Earlier on Discord, it said you were streaming Google Chrome. Not really sure what that was about. It's really good if he misses this turn. I really want him to miss. Okay. That's still fine. Just heal. Crit on that turn. Bot is dead. I do not know why. I What's confusing about it is it's working on PokeGuy's stream, and we have the same bot. Like, they run off the same server, so... Yeah, it's real bad. 22... I have to risk 15. The run's too good not to. I said that backwards. Even with a run this good. Okay, 16. Perfect. How would you crit that turn and it slips on one? Whatever, the crit is still good. No way. Are you kidding me? He was 1 in 16 to Rock Tomb there. And then it rolled 15. Like, are you kidding me? No, but now I'm dead to Peck from the Talo, so I absolutely need to hit the Yolo Ball. And I absolutely cannot justify using a potion here. No universal, that's correct. That's the second time I've been rock tombed from 16 and it did 15. It's pretty dumb. In the square. Are you kidding me? I just have... There's no Yolo Ball for this one. Please. I'm begging you. Okay, easy. Earliest frame. Alright, this run is absolutely insane. This run is basically a minute ahead of my last run. Yeah, seriously. I just can't finish a run. Of course it crits. And it's not like I'm doing, like, YOLOs all the time. I'm just not saving. Which I'm gonna be at that point anyway, so. Norman is just a super bullshit fight. Seems I always get cucked by it somehow, even when I win. Titan Liza is extremely stupid. Those two are the really bad ones. The fights after Titan Liza are also really dumb, and that makes Titan Liza worse. Because it makes it less likely you'll get good HP from it. Because, like, not only do you need to win Titan Liza, you need to win Titan Liza while killing all three of your slaves. They all need to be dead so that you can avoid double battles. And you need to be in Torrent for the fights after. But you can't be too low, otherwise you get fucked over. Flannery sucks, yeah, but it's not as bad. It is pretty bad, though. The Maxie and Archie fights both suck, the second Maxi and then the only Archie fight both suck. Because both of them, you're going up against a Crobat who has Air Cutter. And you'll basically always be in a situation where Air Cutter will kill you if it crits. And it's a high crit rate move. Which means it's only 1 in 8. Actually perfect, except I missed one intentional bonk. The next worst fights after Taten, Liza, and Norman and Flannery is probably Rival 2. And you could potentially put Roxanne in that category. Or Forest Pooch. You don't really consider Forest Pooch though, because it happened so early. Also Gold Split. Twenty-six thirty-three is like insane slate court time. Sub-27s are good, like better than good, and really good Carvana. Comfortably on pace for a 34 Rival 2 right now. It of course comes down to the electrics and the rival fight itself, but like, this is basically a perfect start. 4-turn Treecko, 3-turn Pooch, no encounters, 5-turn Pooch. Yes. I saved like 1 turn on Roxanne. Thank you.
Yep. Play Crystal, you get the better berry in that one. For a number of reasons, Bitterberry is not worth it in gold. The biggest of which is you one-shot the Zubats a good amount of the time. Like the third rocket Zubats in Slowpoke Well. And while yes, it would quote-unquote help on Ralph, if you cure the confusion, he'll just use Supersonic again. So it doesn't, like... Or I should say, he is able to use Supersonic again. However, in Crystal, it's worth it because those three Zubats, you never one-shot them unless you get a good roll crit. Sometimes you don't even two-shot them. And you don't have to replace the berry if it doesn't get used because you main swap. Could have done without that crit, but... Means I'm not getting double growled, so. If you don't like gold, you're not gonna like Crystal, I can tell you that. Crystal has more manips, less margin of error in those manips. The manips themselves are harder. Except for Toto manip. You have to redo LID after every attempt. Three times as many spinners. You do like gold. I thought I remembered hearing you say you didn't like it. This fight is the last major roadblock for a while. Like, aside from spinners, the next dangerous fight is really Flannery. Okay, that's fine. Not getting burned. Important step. Still attacking. Okay. 44. So only a max roll cucks me. Thirty-five is a little annoying, but okay. All right. Don't miss, don't crit. 34. Come on. No, I just missed it. Ugh. This is 41 Watson pace, though. Although this run is more than good enough that I'm gonna mud slap this Magnemite. I'm at 5 HP, which means if I miss the range, I can get cucked. Yeah, sleep. Not risking missing that range. Hidden power crit can do 5, I think. So I just have to dodge that. Get all the ranges from here. This is a 41 Watson. Rip 41 Watson. Nine and 16. And then Mudshot is only 95% to hit. Now, if this is the run that gets past Rival 2, and the last run is the one that gets crit, I'll take it. You know? Last run was like a minute 15 worse than this, at minimum. This is true. For the raid poker guy. This run is quite good. And by quite good, I mean this run is unironically world record pace. course it's not gonna get world record. Headbutt, please. Oh boy. This is happening. Okay. I could have went a lot worse. Rip 41 Watson, but the run's still really good. Thank you for the sub, Yaha Yolo. I was a bit distracted by the Zigzagoon fucking me. Alright, aside from Zigzagoon, this was really good. Alright, time to throw the run away because I haven't practiced mock bike movement in 3 days. Can't believe this. Kind of sloppy, but it's fine. Oh, whoops. I thought I didn't get on the bike for a second. I'm on Pokenav. happy movement. Wow, Omega punished for playing it safe. I literally just need to go to that part and practice that run to bike. And also the turn to bike. I do both those spinner passes safe. You can run to bike that spinner, it's just hard. I should probably just do a slow run to bike, like not try to do it as fast as possible, but still go for the run to bike. God, the movement has been terrible so far. Oh, I need to use the super repel. Don't give me an encounter. What was that? Jesus. Okay, so that was the fastest that spinner could have spun. And he still didn't see me, and I took that super slow. So that is reassuring. I knew the window would be huge there, but. Execution has been very bad so far this split. Way too many mistakes. My bot is down. World record is 2 hours 30 minutes 25 seconds. By Shiru. 666. Terrible execution. Way too many mistakes. All the run to bikes I did do were pretty good though. is quite hard. Like, it's not just a four-frame window, it's a four-frame window to do two inputs, essentially. And they're not in isolation, they're surrounded by a ton of other inputs you have to do right before it. And after. Part of me wants to mudshot my Deanna, but that seems stupid. Like, I only get fucked over if I get bite flinched. Imagine Maxie's perspective when this random girl flies past him at Mach 10 into the middle of a volcano. Sand. Yes. Good. Okay, win the speed tie. Okay, easy. I saw it hit a 95% here, and I can die if I don't. Super potion here. Reminder that that was a bad split. Eh, I mean it wasn't bad. It was, my execution was bad, but not a lot of time loss, I guess. Okay. Turn frame plus two tiles is not safe. That's not the one you need to crit. poison. Very good. But the opposite of Sapphire. In Sapphire, you really want that to poison. Why this run do you miss the range? This is not fair. Are you kidding me right now? She has two hyper potions. Gun that again. Yeah. This is bullshit. Still no Sunny Day up though. I don't know if that thing has Sunny Day. Unbelievable. Better hit! What the fuck was that? I lost 50 seconds to that fight. I've missed that range 3 times ever. Including this run. So, Brawly's stuff doesn't have quick attack, right? Like, I can't think of anything he would have that would have quick attack. Is there any reason to delay healing, though? There isn't. Well, I'm at the wrong side of my bag, so that's a reason. If I miss Mudshot and die, then I just revive. I always bonk there. I don't have a good cue for the column I need to get on. I'm less upset about getting encounter this time because I actually did good movement here for once. That's what I get for saying I did good movement. I can do that movement perfectly, like, every time, but I can't for the life of me bike into Winona's gym. Thank you. Most important 95%. Thank you. Remember when this run was insane? Flannery was bullshit. That was a 5-turn camera up on Flannery. So I just root and rare candy. I probably shouldn't have picked this run to be the one where I do the more powders, less roots. I'm gonna have to use one here. I say thank God this thing doesn't double team. Like, holy shit, if this thing double teamed. Powder. Absolutely going for that every time. Alright, I'll take it. Alright, I want teeter dance spam. Three. Now facade. Wow. Unfortunately, because I wasn't at full health going into this fight, it's not just over yet. More damage. Actually, I'm gonna do this. Low roll. Okay, that's low enough. Max roll, rock smash into counter. Defense drop, please. I'm begging you. Yes. Okay. Mudshot for my life here. Vigoroth and Linoon. Alright, I mean lose time over my gold is what I'm saying. Because, like, all my fights were really good. Basically a perfect Spinda on Norman. Four teeter dances into facade, that's literally exactly what you want. I just got a little cucked because I wasn't at full health. Never do that movement, right? Actually, that section looks good. Never happens. Okay. Alright, so I should still have like 5 powders, 2 roots, right? Yeah. Alright, so I'm like loaded on healing items. Hey. This is a speedrun. If you like speedruns, and you can tolerate me, then you might like this stream. 88% range, and it's really bad if I miss it. Yes, there's still so much that can go wrong. And this run... No, this is on console. GameCube with a Game Boy Player attachment. You're not safe in this run until after you catch Rayquaza, basically. And even then, there are some bad fights for Rayquaza. Ember. Good. That is a 15 and 16 range, and if you miss that range, he might just kill you from fall with Leaf Blade. I don't know how much it does. I've only missed it the range once, and he crit me. It never fails. Unbelievable. Super Troll Wingull, holy shit. That was a gold? Alright, my gold is easily improvable. There. Against a Wingull? Or a Pelipper? Against a Pelipper, Mudshot's not gonna do a whole lot of damage, I can tell you that. But yes, Mudshot is one of the main moves we use for this one. It's currently my best move. No, Surf is better than it now. But for a large portion of the game, Mudshot is my best move. Unfortunately, 95% accurate. Less than ideal. Muddy Water is a bad move. And also, we don't need it. Because, like, immediately after we can learn Muddy Water, we can replace Swampert with something else. Holy shit, that movement. Do that. No. Because I need to pass the spinner right here. If you're asking why do I go right and then go back left, that gets the fly point for Lily Cove. So I can fly to Lily Cove later. Really good. The entire section was really good, except I missed that one run to bike. And I opened bag by accident once. Get on and off the bike there, because it deloads the audio track, which makes the screen transition faster. I actually do a similar thing later in the Ren Romeo. After you do the true double, which is after Tate and Liza, you surf all the way to Pacifilog Town, and then fly back and go over to Sidopolis or Underwater Cavern or however the route goes. I can't remember exactly. Because it gets the fly point. I need to fly there. T-Dog, thank you for following. Aside from Takedown, that's a pretty good moveset. We don't use Swampert all the way to the Elite Four, though. So this is actually our final moveset, except we replace... Hold on a second. God, I'm lost myself. Jesus Christ. That was bad. Now this is our final move set, except we replace Mudshot with Dive. Okay, so Cast Form took a little bit of damage. That doesn't die? My party is Swampert, Cast Form, Abra, Talo. Swampert is the main, Cast Form helps for double battles. Abra is for teleport, but it's going to be deprecated very soon. Talo is for fly. That's the last time we use Abra in the run. Besides for Tate and Liza. Because right here, after this gym, we can use Fly, which is just a better teleport. I'm catching Rayquaza as part of the route. Thank you. Good. You want Cast Form to take a lot of damage. So that it always dies to stuff on Tate and Liza. As long as I don't get crit by Razor Leaf, I'm fine. That fucks me, like, really badly. Need to miss, probably. Alright, not fucked. The most interesting Tropius fight I've had in a while. Got rare candy, elixir. Every time I do this potion strat, I regret it. But I have three potions this run, so it'd be a crime not to. It always works. I did die to the Tropius this run. But you usually die to the Tropius. So much time. Hold on. I feel like I lost way more time than I should have. Like, I know I hesitated for a bit on the double fight, but. Like, yeah, if you crit strength or he misses Razor Leaf. My movement for the windrow section was like really good, so I'm trying to figure out why I lost so much time. All right, good so far. Easy. There's no reason to turn frame before menuing there. Well, Technically, it's slightly faster, but I could have gotten an encounter. It's really stressful. Also, this guy is my favorite trainer in the game. I don't know if you saw his movement, but he says, "My left ear is killing me." Shit, this is actually perfect movement up to this point. I'm definitely gonna mess it up for this next couple parts because they're really hard, but like actually not exaggeration, movement's been perfect so far. Because on his left side, there's a pile of lava. He's not a bitch. It's very simple, come on. Those two sections are really hard to do perfectly. Well, no, it's not that it's loud, it's that it's hot. I knew I was gonna mess up the end. Alright, so Crobat gets a turn, if he crits me, I die, and he has Air Cutter. Lava itself, no. Eruptions are loud, but lava itself doesn't make noise. Okay. We're safe now. Basically safe until Tate and Liza. thought that was dialogue. Like, as soon as I walked in. Caught me off guard. No. No. That guy's just bad at his job. Fame XLR, I think, for following. Sorry, I missed that. Oh, she could have seen me there. Probably. Alright. Work with me here, Gyarados. I need more damage than that. Dragon Rage is good here. Okay. And this kills. Okay, that's perfect. I potion. It's 114. Alright, this is like the perfect setup for Tate and Liza. Potion, and that puts me at 114. Thanks, Fandio. It's slightly high. I'd like to be a little bit lower. But this is well within my range. I'm gonna save for Tate and Liza, don't worry. Emerald, thank you for the raid. Cast Worms in slot 2, I just need to potion at some point. I can potion turn one of the fight, yeah. That's what I do. Let me just make sure that my memory's good. It is. And for the follow as well. I'm sorry, you caught me right before the worst fight of the run. That takes a ton of thinking and planning of how to do it. Squirk, thanks for following. Everything's good. Oops. Alright, that was fast. We save for this fight for a reason. If you get crit at any point during the fight, you die. There are two ranges. If you miss either of them, you die. If you crit at the wrong time, you die. If Castform doesn't die on this fight, it's like your strategy for this fight relies on Castform always dying. And if it's at full health, it doesn't always die. Okay, good. Let's turn on numbers. Okay, good. That means he doesn't do Ancient Power. Which means he doesn't get the boost. If he gets the boost from Ancient Power, you die. Good. That's a good roll. And then he Earthquakes me into Torrent. 35. Okay. That's a little low, but it's good. Those are some really high rolls. Okay, and last thing, this Lunatone is a range. If I miss the range, I die. It's a 15 and 16, though, so it's super likely. Thank you. Okay. You know what? For a second try, that was a very fast 2-try. Hold on. 38. I was at 117. 70. I'm pretty sure that I got, like, almost max rolled twice by the Clay Doll there. Let's take one more of those. We're nowhere near in the clear yet. We use our Swampert for a few more fights. And there are two pretty bad ones. Thank you, Thunder. Still 5 powders and 1 potion. Lonumi, thank you for following. Remember, there was a yes-no this time. So if I take no health, or if I take no damage, I have good enough health all the way for everything. Not yet! We have true double coming up. True double is just a horrible fight. I'm at really good health for it. In comfortable torrent, but can live getting hit. But that... you can still just get screwed over by the AI. $230. It's a $230.25. Thank you, Emerald. I just forgot there's a text box there. Sand or scary face, yeah. That's what I meant to say. Set up your screens, damn it. Good. Okay. Usually Metang sets up reflect and light screen. Him hitting the Mightyena once is useful because it guarantees the range. He should Metal Claw camera up here. Yep. Which is meaningless. It's also meaningless, just lose time. My name is a range. Good. So now it's Golbat, Crobat. I don't know what I want him to do here, actually. I think that's good. Okay, I should win from here. Yeah, okay. If he's psychics here, it should be over. Alright, that was a really good fight. His HP is good. Damn, it's gonna come down to how well I can do Rayquaza Manip, and I can never do it in runs. Each dive, use max repel. I don't have a split for true double. I probably should, but I don't. we complete Swampert's transition to HM Slave. He now has 4 HMs as his moves. I didn't check my surf count, but it should be good. That was one too far. I just don't have this entire layout memorized yet. That's Earthquake, by the way. We skip it. And the reason is because this is the last fight we will use Swampert for. Also, you know, we have 4 HMs as our moves, but, you know. Also, this fight can still kill us, and it's not even unlikely to. Yeah, I'm good on surfs. Don't kill me. Okay, that was a misplay. Okay, we're gonna crit card on that turn. Okay, that's it. Yep. I don't think you need any. Yeah, Rayquaza doesn't need any X-Speeds. In fact, 3 of the 4 Rayquazas are minus speed nature. Well, you have essentially double torrent set up. And Sharpedo has no defenses. Like, at all. Okay, that was close. We're fine. Almost 3 years. Groudon seems a bit outmatched, though. TBH. Vignox, thank you for following. And Leo, my friend, thank you for following. If anyone else followed, I'm sorry I missed it. Devolution, thank you for following. Why did I do that? I wasn't thinking. That's so annoying. Okay, it's one thing, you'll die to surf. It's fine. Oh wait, we try to learn Earthquake or Protect now. Unlucky. Whatever, it's fine. Makes the pass easy next time. Silver linings. Most of this split is dedicated to getting Rayquaza. But also, it literally doesn't matter where you split. Almost made it through no encounters, or no optionals. I just got stupid. Oh, it's... damn it. Come on. You know, Love Disc probably would have died to Strength. I should have just done that. Get on the thing, please. Yeah, let's see if we got good rain RNG. $230.25 by Shiro. My bot's not working for some reason. Put in my other headphone now. Get ready. This is not good rain RNG. This is really bad rain RNG. Wow. Finally did it first try. Jesus. It's not that hard, I swear. Ooh, that was late. Should be quieter, Brave. Be one of the good ones, please. Oh, 236, 246, 241. Those are the HPs I want to see. I don't know why I named it B. 238 is nothing! God, are you fucking kidding me? Actually missed that window. That's super annoying. That was probably the quirky one frame late. I knew it was late, but I didn't think it'd be that late. That should get it. Well, It's not an offset problem this time, it's an... I just fucked that up. Alright, whatever. That's adamant. That's perfectly fine. That's annoying, but it's fine. And my offsets are fine. I just fucked up. Let's not fuck this up, please. Abracadabra, I think you're following. RNG manipulation is what happened. Oh, I need good stats on the Rayquaza. It's a 4-frame window and I missed it. Because I'm bad. Like, this Rayquaza has good attack and a plus attack nature. I am running as PB, yes. The stats of the Rayquaza are determined once you talk to Rayquaza, and then the whether or not it gets in the ball is determined when you throw the ball. There's an asterisk attached to that, but that's close enough to true that you'll get what I mean. And a Pester Poke guy. His notes say fly to Lily Cove here. Obviously you're supposed to fly to Moss Deep. I'm not even close to that. And for the bits. No idea. Sorry. Slightly an awful movement there, but it's fine. use the right moves, please. Outrage everything except for the optional that has three things. Alright, Aerial Ace and Sand Slash first. I have no clue what pace is possible from here. I don't remember at all what my Elite Four is. Well, meant to go right there, whatever. World record in this game is really hard. I was never going for world record. Some bad movement. Yeah, I want to at some point, but... Alright, whatever. I've only been here like 5 times, so I don't have everything memorized here. I have zero knowledge about Gen 4 whatsoever. Well, this is very likely to beat my PB, so... is not in slot one, you idiot. Whatever. Extra aerial ace. Thank you for subscribing. Got past the spinner. I swear I turned. This was a terrible victory road. My movement was sloppy for the entirety of it, but it's fine. I just need to practice it more. I practice it a little bit outside of runs, but not too much. That's annoying. I am playing on GameCube with a Game Boy Player attachment, running it off of GBI. My controller is a Game Boy SP. Okay, I have to go left again at the end of there. GameCube controller is god-awful. No one should ever... I have no idea how people can use the GameCube controller for these runs. So, coming up right here is the only reason that the Adamant is worse than the Braves. Which is the Absol is a range with Waterfall with the Adamant. It is not with the Brave. So if I just get this range, perfect. Okay, I'll take it. Perfect. I can understand liking the Xbox One controller, but I cannot understand the Xbox 360. The D-pad is horrible on it. Stop protecting. Easy. This AI is coded to always protect until you use a move, but it counts the first turn of fly as a move. Eevee only has three different types of Pokemon. What the hell? This fight can be annoying. Best case, I mean, the standard case is she uses Hail turn one. And then you don't miss fly. It's faster if she uses Ice Ball turn one, but she doesn't usually do it. Luckily, airlock is a thing, so you don't take chip damage from the hail. That's pretty nice. But the text is still slow. Seven left. 3 plus 6. Okay, so I have plenty. Alright. Fly's only 90 accuracy, so... Thank you. Fun fact, because Gunner talked to her twice in his world record former world record Sapphire run, I now know that she only has 2 text boxes. I remember it every time, and so I never talked to her twice. Not to split, but whatever. Annoying. By the way, can this thing rock tomb? And if it does, are you supposed to X-speed somewhere? You are, right? It's not in the notes at all. I assume you just do it here. What's Altaria gonna do? Dragon Dance? I know you don't want to do it on Flygon, because you'll set up Sandstorm. So, I guess Altaria makes sense. It just didn't take my A there. That was weird. Like, that is like the only time I can ever say I think the game ate my input. Or there was some lag or something. Because I definitely hit A, and I definitely hit it when it would accept it normally. I'm being serious, like maybe Intimidate had some extra lag at the end of it. I have full health also. Just miss Blizzard. Okay. I don't think it's possible to die from here. I have to do one turn of setup on the Gyarados, but like, even Dragon Dance... No, I outspeed after Dragon Dance, so I'm... Because this is the one... This is the only Rayquaza that outspeeds after a Dragon Dance. So yeah, I don't think Hyper Beam Crit would kill, it definitely wouldn't, so... Yeah. That's it. I got the catch first try, but it was a bad... Rayquaza. The stats were bad, so I had to do it a second time. Okay, Surf. And that's it. Finally hit a Sparkle. Let's go. This should be a 236. Yep, by a lot. And that probably puts me like 6th or something. Oh wow, okay. A lot more people have run Emerald than I thought. Oh right, there's Kurt and Damon and those guys. Oh, Ringo's done English, that makes sense. Thank you, Dexy. So, these splits are going to be cancer to run against. Any 42 Watson is good. This is a 42-12. This is the best I've ever done Slateport. I was annoyed because my PB had a really good Slateport split, so I was always losing time to this. This run gold Slateport, so it's still going to happen. I lost 50 seconds on Flannery because I missed the camera up range twice. It was a 5-turn fight, or 5-turn camera up. I lost a lot of time on Winona, but I don't actually know why. Thank you for gifting 5 subs. Appreciate it. Tate and Liza, I died once, but it was like turn 1 earthquake, so it was fast. Archie was fine. I lost the second try, Rayquaza, and I hit an optional this split. And then Sydney split, my movement can be cleaned up a lot. Yep, I just gotta save 6.5 minutes. Which is really hard. Slayer, thank you for subscribing. Yeah, seriously. I've actually moved into the mid-tier category of runners. Took fucking long enough. And this was the pie run! Attempt 314. 10 Shock, thank you for subscribing. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna... I'm just gonna make a save for later. Am I completed? I think this is my 3rd. Thank you for cheering 50 bits. Alright, so... I just need to actually get Rayquaza Manip first try and run, and beat Tate and Liza first try. And I gotta practice my movement a lot, still. Well, there's 6.5 minutes of improvement, so... Nah, it's too late now. Can't do another run. I mean, I could, but I'm not going to. Fucking 17-11 Roxanne split. This Roxanne split got no encounters and no lost turns, basically. can't do another 2.5 hours of this. Right, let me just. I want to create a save here, so I can practice on it later. So I need some cutscene stuff here. But that's it for me. I'll be back at some point in the future. Can't tell you when. All gold symbols. This was adamant. Oh, is that red and blue for Latios and Latias? I always thought it was Groudon Kyogre. Yeah, I know that. I didn't know that choice is what picked between Latias and Latios. It's been 10 years since I've played this game casually. That's it for me. See y'all later.